Hey, Brokvé Yahweh, Brokvé Yahweh Shai, Brokvé Yahweh, Brokvé Yahweh Shai, Brokvé Yahweh, Brokvé Yahweh Shai. Double honor to the apostles, a great millstone. Honor she brothers will be pushing this truth in sincerity throughout the four corners of the earth. And all praise unto Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. So I wanted to do this quick video going into the fall of America, which is going to end with it being completely destroyed, as you can see from this image that I've I found on the web. And really, the point I was going to go in on this video is how it all began. Okay, so this is the end, thus saith the scriptures, and how did it all begin? And it all began with this word being pushed out there. Okay, so we start first and foremost within the book of Obadiah, okay, the first chapter, and the book of Obadiah, the first chapter. And this is the second verse on down. It says, I've made thee small amongst the heathen. So for a period of time that they was ruling, they was the top people upon the face of the planet. Okay, their merchandise was on point. Okay, their commerce was on point. Okay, Zephaniah 1 and 11 says, how are you inhabitants of Maktesh? For all the merchant people, are cut down, all they that bear silver are cut off. Okay, that is to say, okay, this principal city of commerce, okay, business was going to be cut down. Okay, it was going to be brought down to a low position. Okay, that's why you got it to where China's commerce is coming up. That's seen as a direct threat to the American rule. Okay, you're seeing to these different countries within NATO, they're breaking apart. Okay, so you got the Germans, they don't really want to go down with the plan that America wouldn't go down with. Okay, so that dominance that the American government has had for the longest time is dwindling. Okay, that's why the scripture says what it says. But going back, it says, behold, I have made thee small amongst the heathen. So the hatred towards them, because you ain't talking about commerce in terms of these people being the chief merchants upon the face of the planet, and they've done it in a righteous way. We're talking about these people being the chief merchants upon the face of the planet, and they've done it a completely unrighteous way. Okay, they've had it to where nations have become completely impoverished. They've had it, the whole notion of a third world country as a byproduct of having a global economy that only benefits Esau, okay? That only benefits predominantly Americans and what's known as the Western world, which includes NATO, Britain, etc., etc., of which all of these countries are ruled by one group of people. And you're going to see that these group of people here, okay, their principal home, if you will, or their glory of their kingdom is America. Okay, the what you know as the Western world, the glory of the Western world is America, and the destruction of America is going to come about by way of the scriptures. But it all had a starting point, and that starting point was what? That the word of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai being magnified. Okay, because as we're gonna read down within these scriptures, you're gonna see something that's gonna appear. Okay, as America, as this word started going out there. Okay, and brothers started coming into the realization that they was Israelites, and how the Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai weren't dealing with the whole entirety of the whole planet, but rather was dealing with a specific seed within the earth. Okay, that's when you had it to where this whole thing of having a global economy. Okay, Federal Reserve notes and dollars being the gold reserve currency, that all started going backwards, man. Now, we know the Most High has it to where he's playing Esau. So Esau's out there thinking that he's crashing the economy. But he's going to find out that what? He's crashed his own kingdom in an attempt to set up a new world order of which he had no control over. Okay? So the Most High, he's got the double bluff, if you will. Okay? So the Most High, the Lord's going to make them small. Okay, amongst the heathens, because part of them being made small pursuant to the book of Isaiah, the 47th chapter, is all the iniquity that was done within America. Having it to where the Negroes, Hispanics, Native Americans were carried out there into captivity, served hardcore captivity underneath the people out there within the U.S., underneath Esau, okay, within America, okay, and built up their kingdom. Now they're regarded as scum of the earth. Okay, they're put in movies. Okay, of which when you see a movie, okay, who's the first person to be killed off? It's always Jake. Okay, when you're seeing the depiction that they have of the so-called black woman within these, of which to hell the black woman. Okay, but you got it to where these guys are talking about the black queen and this, that, and the third. When they see the image that they perpetuate for you Negroes, Hispanics, Native Americans to aspire to, it ain't no position of prestige. Okay? And if it is a position of prestige, it will be some prestige that you can't attain. Okay? For instance, that Go Back to Africa movement. Okay? That Go Back to Africa movement is something you can't attain. Because you go down to the way of Africa, Lord's going to destroy you, man. But you grasp on onto this truth as you're seeing brothers doing throughout the four corners of the earth. What happened? You're seeing this kingdom go downwards, man. Okay? So it says, there, behold, I've made these small amongst the heathen. So these different countries are realizing, well, hold on a minute. There ain't no glory here. Okay? Thou art greatly despised. Okay? The pride in thy heart has deceived thee. Thou art dwellest in the clefts of the rock. That's a clue. That's an indicator. Okay? It wasn't the Israelites that dwelt in the cleft of the rocks. It wasn't the Negroes, Hispanics, Native Americans that was dwelling in the cleft of the rocks. Who calls themselves the mountain dwellers? It wasn't the Hispanics. They didn't call themselves the mountain dwellers, as far as I know. Okay? All of these other nations, they didn't call themselves mountain dwellers, but these bankers, okay, these so-called doctors and physicians and, you know, people that's on the top level within this society, okay, the Edomites, okay, they're the ones that call themselves cave dwellers, okay, and whose habitation is high, that saith in his heart, who shall bring me down to the ground? And who brought Esau down to the ground? Okay, the Lord brought Esau down to the ground. And as he was, you know, as he was building the brothers up in the tabernacle of David, what was happening? You saw that Esau was becoming even more desperate. Okay, to the end of the scripture within the book of Revelations, the 12th chapter was going to be fulfilled. Okay, how that he was going to come down having great wrath because he knew he has a short time because the Most High set up the bounds for him that he cannot pass. Okay, truth goes up, Esau goes out. Okay, so let's go into the scripture here. In the book of Amos, the 9th chapter, on the 9th verse, it says, for lo, I'll sift the house of Israel like the corn is sifted. So here it is. It's talking about the sifting of the Negroes, Hispanics, Native Americans. But check what it says out before this. Behold, Amos 9 and 8. Behold, the eyes of the Lord power upon the sinful kingdom, and I will destroy it from off the face of the earth, saving utterly. I will not destroy the house of Jacob. So when the Lord was going to be destroying this earth, what was going to be happening? The Lord was going to be sifting. Okay, how was he going to sift the house of Israel from among all of these nations? He was going to have it to where the teacher wasn't going to be removed into a corner anymore. He was going to be out there teaching. Okay, he was going to have it to where what? He was going to have it to where the internet was going to be the instrument of having it to where this word gets pushed out there. Okay? Right, for Lord, I command, I will sift the house of Israel from among all nations like corn is sifted in the sea, yet shall not the least grain fall upon the earth. Okay? Let's move on to the next precept now. This is going to be within the book of Revelations, the 11th chapter and the 8th verse, okay, regarding the state of the Israelites, okay, the next precept there within the book of Amos, the 9th chapter. So this is Revelations 11 and 8. It says in there, their body shall lie down in the great city, which is spiritually called Sodom and Egypt, where also our Lord was crucified, okay. So when you had, you know, us as a people was out here, okay, suffering, okay, and the scripture says dead bodies, because when you go into the book of Proverbs, it says the man that wandereth out of the way of the understanding, okay, shall remain in the congregation of the dead. So we was regarded as dead, okay, because we was away from our power, okay. But when we got back onto our power, okay, via the elders. Okay, teaching this word. Okay, the scripture says that what? I'll read a 9 and 11 and it will make sense for you. So it says that, and they that are people and kindred and tongue and tongues and nations shall see their dead bodies 3.5 days, okay, which represents the time that we was in hardcore slavery, 350 years, so you can understand. Okay, and shall not suffer their dead bodies to be put in graves. So they wasn't going to give us no understanding. They wasn't going to tell us that we're the Israelites. They was going to look at us and laugh at us. And it says, and they that dwell upon the earth shall rejoice over them. This ain't talking about, it's just zombies, man. This is an allegoric statement, okay, of our history, our heritage, okay. And our history and our heritage, and the upliftment of our people goes hand in hand with the destruction of this place. Okay, when you're talking about the end of America, you're not just talking about the end of America, you're talking about the establishment of the Israelites as the ruling class body upon the face of the earth, and those things go hand in hand. Okay, and it says, we've read that. Okay, the 10th verse, and they that dwell upon the earth shall rejoice over them and make merry and send gifts one to another. Okay, because these two prophets are tormented them that dwell upon earth. And after 3 days and a half, okay, the spirit of life, okay, from the Most High entered into them. Okay, you go to the book of Ezekiel, the 37th chapter. Okay, the word of Yahweh Hashem outside came into us and we was quickened, man. Okay, of life entered into them. Okay, and they stood upon their feet. Okay, and great fear fell upon them which saw. Wisdom of Solomon, the 5th chapter. Okay, and when they heard a great voice from heaven saying unto them, come hither, and they ascended up into heaven in a cloud, and their enemies beheld them. Okay, and when's this going to happen? In the same breath and space as we're seeing within the book of Amos, the 9th chapter. Okay, Amos, the 9th chapter. And now we're starting here at the second verse. Okay, Amos 9:2, it says, though they dig into hell, then shall my hands get them. Though they climb into heaven, thence will I bring them down. So when the Lord is destroying this place, okay, and he beams us up into the chariots, okay, and you got it to where the UFOs are destroying, okay, the nuclear missiles are destroying, okay, you're going to have certain cats trying to avert that, and they're going to dig into hell, they're going to dig into the pits, okay? But guess what? The Most High was going to grab them out. Okay, now let's jump down back down again, okay, into the book of Amos, the 9th chapter, okay, and the 8th verse. Behold, the Lord has low power is upon the sinful kingdom, and I'll destroy from off the face thereof. So even utterly, I will not destroy the house of Jacob, saith the Lord. Okay, for Lord, I will command, I'll sift the house of Israel from among all nations, like corn is sifted in the sea. It shall not the least grain fall upon the earth. All the sinners of my people shall die by the sword, because there's wicked ones of our own people. Okay, which say the evil day shall not overtake us. Okay, so these wicked ones amongst the Israelites, okay, not prevent us. It says, in that day will I raise up the tabernacle of David that is fallen. This is the heart, this is the government, if you will, okay, that is fallen. Okay, and I'll raise up his ruins and I'll build him as in the days of old, that they may possess the remnant of Edom, and all the heathen which are called by my name. So you see, when we get into the word, okay, we get together as a people within the Lord, not as a people of African descent like Esau wants you to be in. No, under the right vibration, no, when we come together underneath the vibration of Yahweh Shai, that's when things pop off, and that's what you've been seeing throughout the world right now. Earthquakes and turmoil. That's a result, a direct result of this word going up. In the days of these kings, Daniel 2:44, in the days of these kings, shall the Most High, the God of heaven, set up a kingdom which shall never be destroyed, okay? And it shall not be left to other people, but it shall break in pieces and consume all these kingdoms, and it shall stand forever. So that must say, all praises unto Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, double honesty, apostle, great millstone, all the sheep brothers that be pushing the truth in sincerity. Shalom.